Hello students, welcome to the English class. Well students, we have already started with this new chapter, Should Wizard Hit Mommy? I have already provided you all with two PPT videos dealing with the theme and analysis of the story. And we have also had another PPT video where we have discussed the character analysis or the characters of the story. We have analyzed the characters of the story, right? I hope you all have gone through the PPT video thoroughly and carefully. So if you have understood the PPT videos very carefully, then we will continue with the explanation of the chapter line by line. Okay. Should Wizard Hit Mommy by John Updike. In the evenings and for Saturday naps, like today's, Jack told his daughter Jo a story out of his head. This custom, begun when she was 2, was itself now nearly 2 years old, and his head felt empty. So in the evenings, okay, especially for the Saturday nap, the evening naps, okay, Jack, the main protagonist or the father of Jo, regularly, it had become a kind of custom or a kind of ritual also, you can say, that regularly every evening Jack would tell a story to Jo, okay, and Jo, while listening the story, would sleep early. Okay, now when Jo was 2 years old, Jack started this custom, and this continued. Okay, now here it is said that this custom began when she was 2, was itself now nearly 2 years old, and his head felt empty. So when Jo was 2 years old, now she has grown up 2 more years. So therefore, Jo's age is how much? 4 years. Jo is 4 years old. Okay. So this 4-year-old girl is still now listening to the same story that Jack had been telling her for the last 2 years continuously. Each new story was a slight variation of a basic tale. A small creature, usually named Roger, it can be Roger Fish, Roger Squirrel, Roger Chipmunk, had some problem and went with it to the wise old owl. The owl told him to go to the wizard, and the wizard performed a magic spell that solved the problem, demanding in payment a number of pennies greater than the number that Roger creature had, but in the same breath directing the animal to a place where the extra pennies could be found. Then Roger was so happy, he played many games with other creatures and went home to his mother just in time to hear the train whistle that brought his daddy home from Boston. So we find that this is the main theme of the story. Okay, now what is the main theme of the story? That is, there is a creature, a small creature, okay, a very small creature. The name of the creature is Roger. It can be fish, it can be a squirrel, it can be a chipmunk or any other animal, okay. But the basic thing is that, number one, okay, this animal had a problem, okay. Number two, the animal went to the wise old owl. Number three, then the animal was directed by the owl to go to the wizard, okay. Number four, the wizard performed a magic spell, okay. Number five, the wizard demanded payment, okay. Then number six, after giving away the money, Roger played many games with other creatures, returned back home to his mother, where he used to wait for his father, who would return from Boston. So in 6, or we can say even 7 also, because later on what happened here, it is also said in number 7, that is, describe their supper and the story was over. Okay, so we find that in 7 different stages the story was made, okay, and the story was the same story, only continued for the continuous last 2 years. The same story is only being continued, okay. So first of all, this Roger, he is a small creature, he had a problem, he went to the owl, directed him to the wizard, created a kind of magic spell, the problem of Roger's, whatever the Roger is, Roger's problem is solved. Then Roger returned back to the jungle, then he played with all the other creatures, went back home where he waited for his father returned back from work, and then they had a nice supper and they said good night to each other and they slept away, right? Okay, and the story was over. Working his way through this scheme was especially fatiguing on Saturday because Joe never fell asleep in naps anymore, and knowing this made the ride seem futile. So, especially on Saturday, it was quite fatiguing. Fatiguing means tiresome. Okay, so on Saturday it was quite tiresome because Joe would not go to sleep. Because maybe since Joe has joined the school, so Saturday was a holiday for Joe. So Joe never went off to sleep so easily in the evenings. Okay, so she would lay awake, and therefore Jack also could not leave Joe. Just in an awake manner, Jack could not leave Joe. And so the entire episode became very much tiresome and very much exhausting for Jack, okay? Because until and unless Joe doesn't go to sleep, Jack cannot move out, or Jack's story would not end, okay? So this was quite a problematic for Jack. The little girl, not so little anymore, the bumps her feet made under the covers were halfway down the bed, their big double bed that they let her be in for naps and when she was sick, had at last arranged herself. And from the way her fat face deep in the pillows shone in the sunlight, sifting through the drawn shades, it did not seem fantastic that some magic would occur and she would take her nap like an infant of two. The girl is little because of age, okay, but not so little when the author is saying here it refers to the height, okay, so don't get confused. When the author says the little girl, he is referring to the small little girl that is of age, but when he said that not so little anymore, here it refers to the height. So though age wise she is little, but height wise she is not so little, because her feet is already quite long enough to cover a half of the bed, the double bed that was there, okay. So Joe was sleeping or lying down on the bed, and her fat face was being dumped into that pillow, okay. And the sunlight only shows that this particular incident had been taking place not at the night time but in the evening time. So it is the evening nap, okay, the noon nap that we already know. So the sunlight was already sifting, little bit of sunlight, rays of the sunlight was entering the room through the shades, through the curtains, okay. And so Jack was imagining that if any magic spell would occur here and Joe would go off to sleep without him telling the story, okay. Her brother Bobby was too, and already asleep with his bottle. Jack asked, who shall the story be about today? And Joe had one brother. He was 2 years old, and Bobby was already with the bottle inside his mouth. He was already fast asleep. So Jack asked Joe that whose story it would be that he is going to narrate today. Roger. Joe squeezed her eyes shut and smiled to be thinking she was thinking. Her eyes opened, her mother's blue. Skunk, she said firmly. So Joe said Roger. No, Roger is obviously, because all the creatures the last 2 years that Jack had been telling the story, it had been of Roger only. Then she blinked her eyes and she pretended as if she was thinking, and then she said skunk. Okay, now when she said skunk, when she opened her eyes reflected the mother's eyes. So Jack could see that Joe had some of the eyes, the facets of the eyes very similar to his wife, okay. So very firmly, okay, this is very much interesting that she said firmly. So here we find that women's dominance or assertion of the role, that yes, what I want, I need it, okay. This female assertion can be found in Joe, okay, and that had been found in Claire also, that is Jack's wife, right. A new animal, they must talk about skunks at nursery school. Having a fresh hero momentarily stirred Jack to creative enthusiasm. So Jack understood that Joe was telling about a new animal. Now maybe because Joe had entered the school, and so in the school maybe the teacher had been teaching them or telling them about skunk, okay. So Joe might be telling about skunk. So that kind, like a new creature had come up or a new hero had come up, that had somewhere risen up the creative impulse of Jack. All right, he said, once upon a time in the deep dark woods, there was a tiny little creature by the name Roger Skunk, and he smelled very bad. Okay, so Jack started with the story, and Jack started that once upon a time there used to live a skunk, little skunk. His name was Roger Skunk, and he had a very bad smell. Yes, Joe said. So Joe was very happy that the story had started, and yes, in the saying that, okay, here is the interesting part, that this Roger had a bad smell. He smelled so bad that none of the other little woodland creatures would play with him. Joe looked at him solemnly. She hadn't foreseen this. So Jack continues the story by saying that the Roger the skunk smelled so bad that other animals or the other creatures of the forest would not play with him. Now Joe had a very solemn face. Solemn means sadly. Okay, so Joe looked towards Jack very sadly because she did not realized that this would be the problem, because Roger had a kind of problem. Roger, any kind of creature, had a problem, and that his bad smell would be the problem, Joe had never realized that. Whenever he would go out to play, Jack continued with zest, remembering certain humiliations of his own childhood, all of the other tiny animals would cry, "Ah, oh, here comes Roger Stinky Skunk," and they would run away, and Roger Skunk would stand there all alone, and two little round tears would fall from his eyes. So Jack continued by zest. Zest means with lots of enthusiasm. Okay, with lots of enthusiasm, Jack continued that Roger would stand there, okay, remembering certain humiliations of his own childhood. In my PPT video on characters, I have told you in the last slide there was given Jack and Roger's affinity, where I have told you that when Jack was telling the story of Roger the skunk, he had given lots of autobiographical details in Roger's story. One autobiographical detail, or the number one autobiographical detail that he had given, was the humiliation of bad smell. So it was understood that Jack, when he was a small child, he also had faced lots of humiliation, and he was embarrassed of the foul smell that used to come from him. Okay, and that may have created lots of humiliation for him in the society. Okay, so this is one of the autobiographical element that Jack had created in the story, or had input in the story. All the other tiny animals, what they would do, they would cry out that, "Oh, there comes Roger Stinky Skunk," and they would run away, leaving Roger all alone, and Roger would stand there seeing that no one is there nearby, so he would cry, okay, some round big drops of tears would fall down from his eyes. The corners of Joe's mouth drooped down, and a lower lip bent forward as he traced with a forefinger along the side of her nose the course of one of Roger Skunk's tears. Okay, now Joe would really feel sorry for this kind of thing. The corners of Joe's mouth, okay, so what drooped down means, what happened, she used to create a kind of sad pout, okay, a very sad pout she would do into her lips, okay, with the lower lip. And what would Jack do? Jack would create a kind of action over here. He would take his forefinger and slide down, okay, would make a kind of sliding from the cheeks of this from the side of the nose of this Joe, okay, and create a kind of action, okay, creating a kind of action and creating a kind of, what we can say, liveliness in narration of the story. "Want to see the owl?" she asked in a high and faintly roughened voice. Now Joe already knows that when Roger has a problem, the next step is that he would go to the owl. Already I have told you the seven stages of the story, isn't it? Please keep that one in mind. It's better you please mark out those seven stages in your book. Okay, so the first stage was what? The first stage was already completed, that Roger had a problem. Okay, now so therefore, since Joe knows this basic, the basic foundation of the story, so Joe asks Jack that, "Won't he go to the owl now?" Sitting on the bed beside her, Jack felt the cover stuck as her legs twitched tensely. Okay, so Jack was sitting by the side, and Jack could realize that the legs of Joe was switched tensely. That means Joe is now deeply inside the story. Okay, she is enjoying the story and she is nervous and tense that what is going to happen to Roger, or how would Roger would come out from this problem, how would he escape the problem. Okay, and that is the most interesting part. First interesting part is what is the problem, and the second interesting part is that how the problem would be solved. Okay, the rest of the part, of course, Joe knows the story very well, right? Well, students, today I have explained you to till her legs switched tensely. Okay, go through the explanation. I have done 2 pages. Okay, go through the explanation carefully. If there is any doubt, please clarify it from me, and please read the text thoroughly. Right? Thank you, students. Study well.